following is a special presentation of Sports Time Ohio.
Watch out, you're in Indian country. Indian fever spreading around. The team is on fire, the flames getting higher. Indian fever is taking the town. Watch out, you're in Indian country. The tribe is alive and we're playing to win. The crowd's on its feet, creating the heat. Indian fever is starting again. Watch out when we're at the plate. Watch out when we're on the field. We're playing to win and you'll be there again. Knowing the fever is for real. Watch out, you're in Indian country. We've got the team and we're ready to win. This is a season, the tribe is a reason. Indian fever is burning again. Watch out, you're in Indian country.
The 1982 Cleveland Indians celebrating 50 years at Municipal Stadium. Indian spring training 1982. A time of high hopes and expectations, not only for veterans, but for rookies as well. Under the watchful eyes of Gabe Paul and Bob Feller, the Indians touted one of the best teams in years. After an active participation in the postseason trade market, there was evidence of a commitment to winning baseball.
We made a lot of trades, and it's just the show to people that the organization in Cleveland is going out and putting the players on the field that can win and be contenders.
Trades that brought players to the Indian organization that complemented an already potent crew of veterans like Toby Hara at third, Mike Hargrove at first, and utility infielder Alan Bannister. The Indians completed the rigors of spring training and look forward to the beginning of the 1982 season. Following their triumphant tour in Tucson, the tribe came home to Municipal Stadium, where winning has always been a trademark. Colorful memories that go back to 1948, a season that spectacularly ended with the Boston Red Sox and the Cleveland Indians in the first ever American League playoff game. 34,000 fans filled Fenway Park to watch as a single game would decide an entire season for the two teams. Ken Keltner's home run in the fourth inning scored Lou Boudreau and Joe Gordon ahead of him as the Indians took the lead 4-1. In the fifth, shortstop Boudreau would hit his second home run of the day and 18th of the season. When combined with a tough pitching performance made by Indian hurler Gene Bearden, the tribe went on to win this historic game 8-3 for the American League pennant and would go on to face the Boston Braves in the World Series. Cleveland Indians fans came out in record-setting numbers for games 4 and 5 as the tribe went ahead in the series 3-2 with a showdown in Boston for game 6. With the game tied at 1 in the 6th inning, Joe Gordon homered into left field for a 1-run Indian lead. Then it was again up to pitcher Gene Bearden, who got Tommy Holmes to fly out for the final out in the 9th, and the Cleveland Indians were the 1948 World Champions, taking the series 4-2. This championship was a complete team victory for the players, as well as manager Boudreau and owner Bill Veeck. The American League pennant returned to Municipal Stadium on September 21, 1954, after the Indians won a record-breaking 111 games. To show their appreciation, the fans of Cleveland came out 250,000 strong, welcoming the team back after the pennant clincher in Detroit. Memories continued to build at Municipal Stadium throughout the 60s and 70s. In 1968, sudden Sam McDowell was the Major League strikeout king and in the same season reached this historic pitcher's plateau. On opening day in 1975, Frank Robinson became the first black manager in the major leagues. Player-manager Robinson also contributed to that opening day victory with this effort at the plate that made for an auspicious Indian debut. While encoring past performances at Municipal Stadium, the most recent and exciting was on May 15th, 1981, as Len Barker pitched himself into the record books. Here's Herb Score with a final out.
Len Barker getting the sign from Ron Hesse. Ernie Witt stands in. Wind up, here it comes. Fly ball center field. Manning coming on, he's there. He catches it. Len Barker has pitched the no-hitter. A perfect game for Len Barker. And the stands erupt, the players go out. Len Barker being surrounded on the field. He has made baseball history here tonight.
And from the perfect game to the All-Star game, just 3 months later, Len Barker's star would shine again as he masterfully retired all six batters he faced in front of the entire country and a sold-out Municipal Stadium. This was a time to be proud of the Indians and the great city of Cleveland. Barker's performance would remind baseball fans everywhere that past Cleveland teams always had their share of great pitching that could send up some fireworks of their own. Pitching greats like Satchel Paige, who was brought into the Cleveland organization by Bill Veeck. In 1948, Satch contributed his share and went 6-1 that World Series year. Mel Harder on the left, who pitched during the 30s and 40s. And Mike Garcia, the Big Bear, who hurled for the Tribe in the 40s and 50s. Early Wynn, who became only the 14th major leaguer to win 300 games. Tough Bob Lemon, a 7-time 20-game winner. Or Herb Score, the Indians' left-handed ace in the 50s. And Bob Feller, the Iowa farm boy who still holds many of the all-time Cleveland records. Rapid Roberts' career accomplishments include 12 one-hitters and an opening day no-hitter against the White Sox in 1940. Bob was also the first American League pitcher to strike out 18 batters in a 9-inning game. And great pitching remains a trademark of today's Indian teams. In 1982, Lenny Barker won 15 games for the Tribe, and he was also the American League's top right-handed strikeout king. Large Lenny got off to a great start last season, winning four of his first five decisions. And he also finished the season strong by winning his last three games in a row. This was also a big year for Rick Sutcliffe, who stepped out of the bullpen and into the starting rotation. Rick became the Indians' most consistent starter, winning the American League's ERA title with a mark of 2.96. And Sutcliffe wound up second in strikeouts to teammate Barker for American League right-handed pitchers. Larry Sorensen struggled through much of this season with injuries, but from April 29th through May 31st, he put together a record of 5-2 with a 1.39 ERA. And Larry also became the first pitcher to throw a shutout in the new Metrodome. And if all Indian pitchers come back strong next season, American League batters better beware. Our Indian pitching story would be incomplete without mentioning the relief work of Dan Spillner. Dan came in from the bullpen and provided the Indians with a much-needed stopper.
I'm finding the challenge to be one of the greatest highs I've ever experienced in the big leagues, because every time you come in, something's on the line. And I've been into a lot of winning decisions this year for this ball club, and I think that I think every ball player really would like to contribute.
And contribute he did, as Spillner finished the year with a record of 12-10, collecting 21 saves along the way with a fine 2.49 ERA. And Dan set two Indian relief records for right-handers with wins and saves.
When you shop at Levin Furniture this weekend, you win. Because now through Sunday, buy furniture or a mattress at Levin's and get a high-def flat-screen TV free. That's right, free. The more furniture you buy, the bigger the screen, up to 50 inches in awesome high def. Don't need a free TV? Get free furniture. An extra 25% bonus on everything in the store. Free TVs or free furniture through Sunday only at Levin's.
How to have fewer hangovers. Method 1, don't drink. Hangover avoided. Method 2, take Chaser while you drink and wake up feeling great. Breakfast in bed not included. Let's review. Method 1, don't drink. Method 2, take Chaser while you drink. Wake up feeling great and cute as a button. Individual cuteness may vary. If you get hangovers, try Chaser. Just take 2 pills with your first drink and 2 more later. The choice is yours. Don't drink or don't drink without Chaser. Please drink responsibly.
The holidays are almost here, so why wait? Shop early, shop smart, and jumpstart the holidays at B&B Appliance. All the latest styles, all the leading brands, all priced to go. Save on our huge selection of quality appliances, high-definition home theaters, and more. Plus, save with Frigidaire quality and get Frigidaire performance and Frigidaire value. Shop early, shop smart, and save at B&B Appliance today.
The Browns take on the Raiders on December 27th at Cleveland Browns Stadium. Tickets are still available and start at just $32. For more information, call 440-824-3434 or visit clevelandbrowns.com.
Lexus Sunday Strategy. Sports Time Ohio's own football experts break down the upcoming matchups of the Cleveland Browns. Expert in-depth analysis of all the X's and O's. Lexus Sunday Strategy, Thursday night at 7 on STO.
Although Municipal Stadium has enjoyed great pitching over the years, it also had its share of outstanding hitting. Like Al Rosen, here with the first of 2 home runs in the 1954 All-Star game played at Cleveland. Or the player manager Lou Boudreau, who could really sting the ball around the diamond. And strong hitting continued in 82 as Toby Harrah would have his best year ever at the plate.
And this season, I just worked real hard in spring training. I tried to be more aggressive and pull the ball, hit more home runs this year. And I've done that, and really the average has just been a plus because I haven't hit in second. It's tough to hit for average. You have to move the runner a lot. You got to take a lot of pitches when guys are stealing. So the average has been really a bonus for me all season long because I've basically just been trying to drive the ball.
Toby hit safely in 40 of the first 42 games last season while batting .397 in April and .382 in May. Toby finished the year batting .304 with 25 home runs and 78 RBIs. It was the first time Toby hit .300 and played in 162 games, and it was the second time he'd scored 100 runs. Another Indian with a tremendous year at the plate was designated hitter Andre Thornton. After 2 years of injuries, Thunder was back with a solid .273 batting average. And he was near the top of the American League in a number of offensive categories with 15 game-winning RBIs, 31 home runs, and 116 runs batted in. Andre's 31 homers tied the American League record for the most home runs in a season by a DH.
Well, you know, I don't look at it as totally different than a lot of other seasons I've had, except that, sure, when you have seasons like this, of course, certain things fall into play. The situations to drive men in have to be there. You have to have men having good seasons in front of you. And then you have to be able to be hot during those times when they're there.
Andy, you were awfully hot this season. Try to keep some of those embers burning for 83. Another Indian on the warpath in 1982 was acrobatic center fielder Rick Manning. Rick began the year at the plate strong by hitting in 13 of the first 15 games and finished the season with a consistent .270 batting average against right or left-handed pitching. And as Indian fans know, once Rick gets to first, he's a real threat on the base paths. Another productive performer for the Indians was ever-steady Mike Hargrove. Hargrove collected 160 hits and 101 walks for a .380 on-base percentage near the top of the major leagues. Mike put together one 9-game hitting streak and 2 others of 10. Mike would also set personal season highs of 591 at-bats and 8 game-winning RBIs. An all-around ball player, Mike also enjoyed another good year at first base, committing just one error in the first 4 months of the season. But fans best remember Mike for his unique batting style that's been entertaining them for years.
Hargrove steps out, bangs the barrel into the bat against the shoes, reaches behind him to the left hip pocket, readjusts the glove, readjusts the donut he wears on his left thumb, flexes the shoulders, touches the helmet, readjusts the glove again, goes to the nose, again a readjustment of the glove, again a readjustment of the donut, readjusts the glove, flexes the shoulders, touches the helmet, readjusts the glove again, goes to the nose, again a readjustment of the glove, again a readjustment of the donut, bangs the barrel into the bat against the shoes, reaches behind him to the left hip pocket, readjusts the glove, touches the helmet, readjusts the glove again, goes to the nose he wears on his left thumb, flexes the shoulders, touches the helmet, readjusts the glove again, goes to the nose, again a readjustment of the glove, again a readjustment of the donut, and now Hargrove is ready.
And often Mike would make it all worth the wait by connecting with the ball for extra bases. Mike was just one of the many reasons fans came out in big numbers to the lakefront last year. And for the third year in a row, Cleveland would lead all clubs in opening day attendance figures with over 64,000. And the Tribe also recorded the single game high attendance mark with almost 70,000 fans. But the fans were coming out to the park for more than just a ball game. They were coming out for events like Autograph Ball Day, when fans received a free ball and could get their favorite Indian signature on it. And whether you came out for a hot dog, a cold beer, or just to be with friends, you know, the cookouts behind the playing field were just the place to be before game time. And those cookouts are quickly becoming a most enjoyable tradition at Municipal Stadium. It was a very good year indeed, as overall attendance figures at the stadium were the largest in eight seasons. At 1,044,000, it marked the third time in 4 years the Tribe had drawn a million or more fans to the lakefront. And the physical aspect of the park was not limited to just the playing field. In the end, it was the game and efforts of the Tribe that entertained the faithful who came out to cheer on their favorites. The Tribe had them on their feet a lot last season, and base stealing, the great new tradition at Municipal Stadium, was the reason why. The Tribe finished second in the American League with 151 thefts, the most for an Indian team in 63 seasons. And it marked the fourth year in a row that the Tribe had stolen 100 or more bases. The team was led by speedsters Miguel Delaney and Von Hayes, and rounded out by fellow base stealers Alan Bannister, Rick Manning, and Toby Heron. It was a team fast enough to challenge the best American League catchers, as if to say, you won't catch us often because we ride like the wind. And all that streaking on the base path just delighted Cleveland fans. And so would another kind. This time it was an 11-game winning streak that was tops in the American League last season. After winning four games on the road, the Tribe came home to play the red-hot White Sox. Down 2-0, up steps Mike Hargrove.
Ground ball up the middle into center field, a base hit. One run scores. Here's Naharadny. Going to third is Hera. The Indians have tied it in the third. Mike Hargrove.
And the Indian streak was alive at five. In game six, the Indians faced a tough Lamar Hoyt with his own personal 9-game winning streak on the line. At the plate for the Tribe, Alan Bannister.
And the 0-1 pitch to Banny, a line drive, base hit down the left field line. Hesse will score, Manning will score. The Indians take a 4-0 lead.
And that is the most runs that Lamar Hoyt has given up in any game this season.
In the series finale, Andre Thornton provided the muscle to win game seven.
Long drive, left field, way back, and the fence is tipped. It is gone, home run. Andre Thornton, it's number 13. He gets three RBIs, the Indians lead 3-1.
And 2 days later, Cleveland's DH did it again.
And here it's the big T up at home plate, Andre Thornton. The stretch, and the pitch, there's a drive, deep to left field. Back goes Hatcher, back, she goes, and it's gone. Can you believe it?
The Indians had become a team to be reckoned with and were making their bid in the American League East. But injuries would throw a curve into the Tribe's plan. Most damaging to Cleveland's hopes last year was the early injury to Burt Blyleven, the Indians' top pitcher in 81. Burt would require surgery and was gone for the season. Another Cleveland ace, Rick Waite, suffered through most of the season with tendonitis in the knee, and surgery would remove him from the lineup too. Alan Bannister, who did it all for the Tribe in the field last season, was out for a month with a pulled hamstring, which would also hurt the Tribe on the base paths. And finally, Bake McBride, who only played in 27 games last season after an eye injury. With Bake out, the Indians lost a great glove, fast feet, and a big bat. And although these injuries stymied the Indian efforts, it provided some rookies with valuable playing time. Like Neil Heaton, who came up in September. He was 10-5 in Charleston last year with a 4.01 ERA. The Indians' number two pick in the 81 June draft appeared in 8 games for the Tribe, 4 as a starter. Kevin Romberg was also called up in September from Charleston, where he hit .304 and stole 45 bases in 100 games. Kevin made his presence in the majors known with his first major league home run against Boston on September 8. When he came up in July, Carmen Castillo played every field for Cleveland, showing both a strong arm and good speed. And finally, Bud Anderson. Used primarily in relief, Bud posted a record of 3-4 with an ERA of 3.35. Bud was very impressive at the stadium where he won 3 of 4 decisions.
Game's on, changing the channel.
I don't think so.
Easy, sweetheart. I'm only canceling Billy's recording.
No, you're not. Drop them, both of you.
Sorry, Billy. Happy Pony's on. And I'm not missing Happy Pony.
Guys, we're family. We can work this out.
Has anyone seen my... Never mind.
End the conflict. Only AT&T UVerse lets you record up to 4 shows at once on a single DVR. Switch from cable today. Get up to $200 back via promotion card.
Buying a used car is simple at Pat O'Brien Chevrolet, home of upfront pricing. They always have a great selection of GM-certified used vehicles. The experts check everything from the exhaust system to the cup holders in a 117-point inspection. The vehicles are backed by a 100,000-mile, 5-year powertrain limited warranty, and you get roadside assistance. So when you drive home your GM-certified used vehicle, all you have to worry about is showing it off to your friends. At Pat O'Brien Chevrolet, we'll save you time and money.
In today's economic climate, you might think it's impossible to get credit to buy a car. We have news for you. In fact, financing is available, and there's never been a better time to buy a car or truck. Your local dealer has access to multiple sources of credit and will work with you to find financing that meets your needs. Take advantage of great incentives, rebates, and low interest rates. Vehicle quality and fuel efficiency are the highest ever. Now is the time to buy. A message brought to you by the National Automobile Dealers Association.
1983 are the trades the tribe made for the immediate future. The Indians obtained Juan Eichelberger from the San Diego Padres in a three-player deal. The hard-throwing Eichelberger can be used either as a starter or in relief. Juan adds yet another strong arm and experience to a seasoned staff already on the roster. Also coming over from San Diego is Broderick Perkins, who has been touted as one of the best pinch hitters in the National League and will add some extra bench strength in 82. Baseball's biggest trade of the year brought three-time Gold Glove winner Manny Trio to Cleveland. In 82, Manny set a major league record by going 89 consecutive games without a single error. Manny's talent will certainly bolster the Indians' infield. George Vukovich is another player coming to Cleveland from Philadelphia. George provides the tribe with a proven bat at the plate and an experienced glove in the outfield. Also involved in the trade are promising right-hander Jay Baller and catcher Jerry Willard. But of the youngsters coming over to Cleveland, Julio Franco's star burns the brightest as he's considered one of baseball's best prospects. Julio will be an Indian shortstop of the future. But the most significant postseason move by the Indians was the signing of Mike Ferraro.
Mike Ferraro is our manager, and I think that Mike has been with some very, very able coaches with him. So, Mike Ferraro, it's yours.
So I would just like to say that I'm very happy and excited about being manager of the Cleveland Indians. I think the ball club has a lot of potential here. I think, when you look to, build a ball club or start with a ball club, you look...
Mike comes over from the Yankee organization, where he's worked his way up the baseball ladder and enjoyed much success in the minor leagues. And last but not least, congratulations are in order for Andre Thornton, the American League's 1982 Comeback Player of the Year.
As a professional athlete, you're continually vindicating your ability year after year and doing things that over and over again, because everyone seems to forget what you've done in the past. So it's nice to be able to come back when everyone thought that maybe you were through, and show them that you have, I hope, quite a few years left.